Hi, everybody, and welcome out to All City Field. We're in Denver for high school baseball here on CET Sports. DPL matchup as Denver East takes on Thomas Jefferson.
True third baseman, not really sure what that means. I do know it means he's pretty gritty, used to having balls coming at him pretty quick. Best athlete on the team, certainly, and he can certainly swing the bat a little bit. And he's somebody who's going to move on to college, as you'd mentioned, Brian. But again, he's one of those leaders on this.
Boy, just a beautiful shot as you look back west here from All City Field in Denver. DPL baseball action on a Wednesday afternoon. It's TJ, and it's Denver East. Let's take a look at that Thomas Jefferson lineup here this afternoon. Thornton, the second baseman, leads off. Van Dyke has some power. We talked about Thomas. Freeland on the mound. Walter, a freshman, making his first start. Turner and Maloney. And on the mound here this afternoon for the East Angels, Anthony Wilson. The right-hander. Wilson has a plus curveball. Goes 12-6. He's a guy that will be playing some junior college baseball coming up next year. And we are underway. That they virtually didn't bring back any varsity experience from last year. That's a good curveball. There it is, Corey.
Yep.
And he gets his first punch out of the afternoon. A fastball just missed outside on the payoff pitch. Let's take you around that defense for Denver East here this afternoon. We mentioned Wilson on the mound. Porras is behind the dish here today. Hager playing third. Max Bridges at short. Zavala at second. And then we just moments ago got a glimpse at Houston over at first base. Left to right in the outfield, Zettis, Lehman Miller, and Brown. That's the defensive setup for the East Angels this afternoon. Runner goes, swing and a miss. Throw down by Porras. Did they get him? You bet they did. Beautiful throw by Porras. And there's two down.
Right on the money. You know what? Kind of a late throw by Porras. He didn't bobble it necessarily, but it was just a, it took that moment. I wondered if he'd get it there in time, but the throw was right on the money. Right on the back of the runner there. And that's easy for an infielder to just lay the glove on top of the out.
Curveball grounded left side of the infield. Bridge on the backhand, long throw, not going to be there in time. Ball will get away from Houston.
Play, so an infield hit.
And Dyke swings at the first pitch he sees. That's lined into right field. Holding up at second base is Needham. And now runners at first and second with two down here in this TJ first inning.
He's waiting for a pitch that he can hit. He wants that fastball.
And swing and a miss. Big strikeout with a pair of runners aboard for Anthony Wilson. We're done with half inning here at All City Field. So we head here to the bottom half of the first inning. Let's take a look at that East Angel lineup here this afternoon. Anthony Wilson, the pitcher, will lead him off. Bridge, the hit second. Lehman Miller, followed by Zavala, the second baseman. Hager, Houston, Porras behind the dish. Nick Brown and Jacob Greenwood is the designated hitter here this afternoon, hitting instead of the left fielder, Elliot Zettis. And on the mound this afternoon, Kyle Freeland, the left-hander. On the season, Freeland, guy that has a 3.20 earned run average. He's 1-0 on the year in Corey. He throws something that you don't see often at the high school level. He has a wicked knuckleball. We're looking forward to see that many times here this afternoon. Opens up Wilson with a fastball upstairs. Again, Freeland on the mound, the lefty. Grant Maloney is behind the dish. His brother Max Maloney was the DJ catcher the last 3 years. And, of course, his father Tom Maloney, former GM of the Denver Zephyrs, former AAA affiliate that was here in Denver before, obviously, the Colorado Rockies came aboard. There's a walk to Wilson. He'll take his free pass. And then Evan Walter, the young freshman, making his first ever start. Big swing and a miss there. And the count is 0-1 here to Max Bridge. Outfield left to right, Deshaun Turner, Sean Thomas. Check that, Sam Thomas. And in right field, it's Chris Van Dyke.
Get that arm moving fast and hustle to the plate because it stops it from dancing.
That ball popped up. Playable. First baseman Walter camping underneath this one. Backs up on it, makes the play. First out of the inning. Here's Jamie Lehman Miller hitting third this afternoon, playing center field. In fact, there are two undefeated teams in the DPL League coming into action today. That went right back up the middle. Could be two. Stepping on second to second baseman Thornton to first. That gets away from Walter. They do get the force out at second. And Lehman Miller will take second base on the errant throw.
All right, now,
here's the second baseman, Walter Zavala. That's the last day of the regular season. But TJ is going to be playing 7 games in 8 days, and the runner will go in safely as Lehman Miller at third base.
You don't want to burn up arms.
A two-out base hit back up the middle, and Lehman Miller will score easily. RBI single for Walter Zavala, and Denver East has struck first. It's 1-0.
Errors will hurt you, and of course, Lehman Miller reaching on the fielder's choice, but the overthrow by Thornton at second advanced him to second, and he was able to get to third on a pass ball. Beating a 5A team is a bonus, but beat your 4A teams, and that's who they've got coming up here. We've got a couple of those on the way here in the next 5 days.
Added from that viewpoint, runner goes, and they got him. Throw to second here, and indeed. So Zavala will get caught off first base. We'll finish that thought as we come back. One inning in the books. A run on a hit for East. They strike first. They lead 1-0 after one. But 1-0 the score as we head to the second inning of play here. All City Field in Denver in 2008. Well, here's Freeland. Bounces it to the left side. Hager, the third baseman, up with it. Clean throw. In time, one up, one down here in the TJ second. For junior varsity and now up here at the varsity level. But 16 home runs in the season at the lower levels. Now making a varsity debut, and he goes down swinging. That ball flared into the outfield grass, but the shortstop Bridge had the beat. Three up, three down in the Spartan second inning. We're through 1.5. Others, East head coach Howard Carr, she's in his 12th season leading East Angels baseball. Limping a little bit, he tore a calf muscle just a couple days ago. He says it's going to be ugly watching me walk around the diamond here this afternoon. Enjoyed our conversation with him. Boy, he has a lot of baseball ties around the state. Former head coach at Mullen, coached at Boulder, Fairview, and Pomona as well.
Full time in the college ranks, University of Oklahoma, grad assistant, and then a part-time coach there. So he's got some skills, got a little knowledge. 19 pitches in that first inning for Freeland. Like to cut that down a little bit.
Here's Lars Hager, swings at the first pitch he sees. Thomas back on his horse, that'll fly over his head. All the way to the fence. And Hager will hold up at second. A lead double for Hager and the Angels here in the second.
Interesting, you got another lefty up there in Houston, and so Freeland decides to throw that slider a little. Another lefty up there, even though your arm angle's right at him, you're at a bit of a disadvantage.
Ground ball to the first baseman, Walter, up with it. That will advance the runner.
Again, you've only got a one-run lead here. You put that up in the first, but again, it just every little run counts.
Ivan Pors, here's the squeeze, and Freeland has one play only at the first base. Executed perfectly, and coming home to score is Hager. In a rivalry standpoint between East and TJ, but Denver West coming up tomorrow is the more important game because it's against a 4A opponent. Talking to Torrey Humphrey, thought that perhaps East would be expecting to see the more of a power pitcher in Chris Van Dyke here this afternoon.
Yeah, you want to beat East, and you certainly want to give them a good game here, but got to save those arms.
Payoff pitch, and they got Nick Brown on the strikeout. But a squeeze will bring in Hager, and Denver East through two. They lead their rival, the TJ Spartans, 2-0.
They'll face off against the number 9 hitter, Grant Maloney. 9-1 and 2 hitters. First pitch swinging. Hello. Right back to Wilson it comes. He'll flip it over to Houston. And there's one down. Kern will follow. Chopper going to the left side. Going to have to hurry. Bridge got to it. Throw it from the back foot. Scooped up by Houston, but the runner's there in time. Just teed it out. Nice little scoop there by Houston. It's a couple times that Bridge has bounced it over there because he's had to throw from that back foot.
That was a good job of Bridge just by getting to the baseball in the first place. That was deep in the hole, and then he had to throw the youngsters into the fire.
A off pitch, missed it outside, so the runners are going to move up here. Austin Hearn did a nice job battling against Wilson.
Go back to the fastball, get back in the count here. Now it's 2-1, you're okay again.
Another fastball, snagged by Wilson. He's going to go to second and throw it right between the middle infielders. Bridge and Zavala didn't know who was going to make the play, and coming around to score will be Thornton there. And that is the first error of the game against East, and suddenly the lead cut in half.
You're the shortstop. You have to get over there now. The shortstop, Max Bridge, was talking to the infield umpire, thought there could be base runner interference.
Another chance for two. Bridge goes to Zavala over to first. In time, they get the twin killing to end the inning, but all the error is costly. It cost them one run here. Run on a hit. Runner left on as well, and that one error, it's 2-1. East is up on TJ. Bottom of the order, DH. This is Jacob Green with the lead things off, and we'll go back to the order with Wilson and Bridge. Might have been a knuckleball. Never know. Here's the 1-1. Weedwood pops it up right near the mound. Hearn coming in, the shortstop, and by the mound to make the catch.
We saw a lot of wind and some rain as we were preparing for production.
High pitch, swung out to the gap in left center fielder. Is going to come over. Thomas makes a nice catch on the run.
When the center fielder makes that call and you're on the run, you tailing behind him.
That's right. Get out of the way. And peeled off correctly behind him to get any ball that might have gotten away. Max Bridge up there now. He lying down to Walter over there at first his last time up. Actually popped out. That put it up there in the wind. You know what? The wind that's blowing out to the corner, you got a lefty on the mound who can throw a knuckleball, as Torrey Humphrey told us. With that wind, that just makes that knuckleball dance even more. I'm surprised he hasn't tried it a little more often.
It makes it a little more squirrely, doesn't
it?
Yeah.
You gotten one yet?
Payoff pitch again. Slider off the end of the bat to the right side. Walter's going to get to it, and he'll step on the bag himself that time. Here we go, top of the fourth. East out there in the field, turned away for the first time in three innings. Going to run up in the first, run on the second, but three down inning for Freeland on the mound for TJ, and coming up to bat, 5, 6, and 7 intercepts to lead things off. TJ got a run in the last inning. See if they can put another run up there. Thomas will take it right off the old shoulder blade that time. He leads the team in being hit by pitches. Isn't he the one? One of the players. And then that looked like, you know what's coming in? I'm going to take one for the team. Now, Wilson kicks and comes home. Flared out toward left field. Is that a pretty good beat on it? Didn't have to move much. Looking into the sun, but makes the catch. And Thomas will have to retreat to first. 14, 15 years old. Fastball inside with it, and another payoff pitch. Walter does a nice job. He'll take the walk here, push Thomas over to second.
Thomas.
Wheeling, uh-oh. They got Thomas picked off there, and he is tagged out. Leaning the wrong way, thought maybe Wilson was going to go home. He was going to, I think he was really thinking about stealing third that time. And a nice job by Wilson to pick him off.
Well, an outbound Wilson, the speed from the East pitcher. He did a nice job there. Why risk a throw when you can just run him down from the pitcher spot?
There's no way he was going to go to second on that, just because Wilson ran down Thomas there. Fastball popped to the right side. Shallow right field. Brown drifted back and now coming back in. That wind pushed it out to him, though, and he'll gather it in for the third out of the inning. Well, a runner left on here. No hits and certainly no runs. TJ still down to East here by one run as we go to the bottom of the fourth. Pulling out for his fourth inning of work here. A couple of runs on two hits. 43 total pitches here. Pretty economical. TJ turned away in the top half of the inning, though, so still trailing by a run. And Freeland is going to have to face the heart of the order. 3, 4, and 5 hitters. Lehman Miller to start things off. Before the game, the wind blowing so much, it tipped the scaffolding a little bit. Pulled through the left side of the infield, a hit by Lehman Miller on that fastball, and he'll deliver it out there to left field, and a leadoff runner is on for the second time in four innings here. Third time in four innings, I should say.
Tell you what, the effectiveness that you're going to have as a pitcher increases exponentially. They got another.
Picked off Lehman Miller. Throw to second. Now just wait for him there. Well, a little fake out. Not a bad move by Lehman Miller, but it wasn't enough to fake out Hearn, and he'll slap the tag on the head as he falls over the top of it. Full count here. Freeland working on Zavala. Zavala, this single back of the first was first pitch swinging. This one a fly ball to right. Van Dyke underneath it, waiting for it to come down, and has it. That wind has turned a little bit. It's blowing in a little bit now from left field. Now the wind has changed directions here two or three times in the three or so hours that we've been here. Fastball, this one, a ground ball to the right side of second. Thornton there in time, struggled a little bit, could not make the throw in time for the third out. He tripped trying to get to that ball. Just a little slip that time, and it threw off his timing, and he ended up having to throw it off the back of his foot. So an infield single there for Lars Hager. Well, and Freeland's done a nice job, too, with his delivery. He'll cover that slide step. Every once in a while, he'll pick that leg up, and there's that high leg kick. Runner will go, and it bounds away from Maloney behind the dish. And rounding second is Hager trying to get to third, and is he in there? You betcha. He never slowed down going around second. We talked about the room that was behind the dish here. It took a long time for Maloney to track that down. Runner at third, two outs here. Casey Houston, the payoff pitch to him, and a punch out about letter high. It's just the second strikeout of the game for Freeland, but it's a big one here. Turn away east, with a runner standing 90 feet away. Angels still up, 2-1.
Again, it's based around him throwing that curveball for a strike.
Reaching out, knocking that one down. Zavala covering Wilson, he got there in time. Houston actually at first, they say he missed the bag.
Boy, I'll tell you what, it's tough to tell from up here. And again, the umpire, this guy's been doing a nice job, and he was right on top of it. But from our camera vantage point, I certainly thought he got him.
Didn't even think twice about it.
I thought he got the bag. He was there in plenty of time. I thought he did get on the bag. Now, it wasn't a clean touch of the foot on the bag, but I still think he got it.
Well, there you go. We'll see how this affects, because Wilson, your pitcher, is a guy who jumped off the mound, got over there, covered it on a nice play by Houston, and did exactly what he needed to do, thought he did, and now he's got a runner over there at first.
And that's assistant coach Kevin Simler that was out there arguing the call. And again, I'll tell you what, Thornton's not a very big hitter up there, and he crouches down.
Inside jammed him, popped to the left side. Bridge giving chase, falling down. It's going to fall in there for a single. Oh, Max Bridge is so close with the wind up, but nobody out. Austin Hearn up there now, square to bunt, hit it right back to Wilson. Wilson's got one play, got to go to first. Houston will snag it. That's one away there, but runners at second and third now. Here's the 1-2. Curveball. Fly ball out towards center field. Lehman Miller is drifting into the gap to make the catch. Runner will tag at third. Maloney on his way home. Not in time. He was thrown out by two or three steps. What a gun from center. Well, it's still a 2-1 lead for the East Angels thanks to defense. We go to the bottom of the fifth here. East will come up to bat, still holding that 2-1 lead. You know, the Angels are missing a huge portion of their team. Addison Squibb's sophomore sliding, actually going for a ball, I think, fell down in the infield, ended up with a bruise, and it didn't really go away. They took him to the hospital, found out that he's got cancer. He found this out about 2 weeks ago. It's non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. But going through his second round of chemo here, and the team actually in the dugout, they every once in a while for the games, they'll bring a cardboard cutout of Squibbs just to make sure that they remember him and what he's battling through. But he, you know, coach was talking about it. It's such a huge loss for them. Good kid, but Howard Carr says, great athlete as well. And so teams really had to battle through some adversity here over the last couple of weeks.
That's really an unbelievable situation, too. I mean, just 2 weeks ago, you're a normal high school kid.
Yeah.
sophomore, and again, he was a pivotal part of this Angel baseball team, which obviously takes a big back seat when something like this happens. But you're a normal high school baseball player 2 weeks ago. Next thing you know, he's undergoing his second wave of chemotherapy. And again, as Corey mentioned, non-Hodgkin lymphoma. Well, according to Howard Karsh, their head coach, it looks like it is going to be beatable.
Yeah.
Boy, that's a long fight ahead for Addison Squibbs. And that's an unbelievable story when you hear something like that. It comes, and it's been part of the pun, but it comes from left field.
Oh, yeah. No, I think that's a perfect pun there. It's just the way that, you know, that Howard Karsh described it to us, too, 2 weeks ago. And you go, wait, you kidding? The guy was a big part of the team here, going to school, normal everyday high school activities, and suddenly, you know, he's at Children's Hospital now.
Yeah, certainly our thoughts and prayers are with Addison Squibbs and his family. The CET folks are thinking about you.
Porras up there, 2 balls, 2 strikes. Freeland with the delivery off the end of the bat to the right side. Thornton the opportunity here. He's right on that. And a good hard throw to Walter. And there's one down. A run and 3 hits for TJ. Pitch misses outside, and Brown will head down to first here.
Designated hitter, number 11, Jacob Greenwood.
And his coaching staff were part of that Denver South staff. So when TJ and Ralston Valley hooked up last year.
Here's the 1-1. High pitch is bunted to that left side. Up with it. Mankoff's got one play and a nice scoop over there by Walter for the second out of the inning. Wilson 0-for-1 today. Flew out to Thomas out there in center. Pretty deep shot to the gap in left, but Thomas tracked it down. Tomahawks this one straight up. Walter calling for it, and he's going to take it there at first. And it's out of the inning. Runner stranded for East. Still a 2-1 lead for the Angels. They're up on TJ here as we go to the Angels hanging on 2-1 here in the wind. Out to right a little bit. Five to Jorge Lopez, Brian Roth alongside as we head into the sixth inning. TJ coming back to bat. Brian Roth take over. Well-pitched ball game here.
Here's the 2-1. Got inside on a ground ball. Third baseman Hager over to first in time. One up, one down in the TJ sixth inning.
Pretty economical, 4 pitches there, total of 76 now for Wilson. And both pitchers done a nice job as they've gone through, both of them have gone through 5 innings now. Pitch count right around 70. You could extend them another inning if you want to, and obviously Wilson going here into the sixth.
Here's Sam Thomas, fastball, got inside again. 0-1, Thomas. 0-for-1 this afternoon, struck out back in the first, then was hit by a pitch in the fourth. Drives this one into right field, taking a step back on it is Brown, and it'll get past him. That'll roll to the warning track. Thomas on his way to second. He'll hold up there.
Now, I think this is Wilson's game to keep in the sixth.
That ball sliced down that left field line, and it'll land foul. Zedis got a pretty good jump on it out there in left field, but wasn't able to get to it. Elliot Zedis being DH for here this afternoon. Of course, Corey Lopez, you can hear him, 850 KOA. Ground ball back up the middle, sharply hit. Rounding second is Thomas. He'll score easily. Raymond Miller was able to come up with it cleanly out in center field, and we're tied at 2.
Of what's coming.
Swing and a miss. Wilson got the fastball by the freshman. So a big strikeout. Second time Walter's been sent down swinging. It's the fourth strikeout this afternoon for the right-hander, Anthony Wilson. That'll bring up Deshaun Turner. Turner 0-for-2 this afternoon, lined to the shortstop bridge. Runner goes. Porras, the throw down. It was a good throw, but bobbled a bit. Safe at second with a stolen base.
Pushing the issue a little bit, get a runner in score position. That's the lead run.
Turner laying down a bunt. Boy, is that a good one. Good speed for Turner. Did they get him? No, they did not. That was a perfectly placed bunt by Turner.
Wow, that's blazing speed there.
And there's Howard Karsh going to go out and talk to the crew. He saw Howard limp out there. And again, a couple days ago, coaching third, he tore that calf muscle. I cannot feel good. That certainly limits your mobility. Having a word with his infielders here. 2-2 baseball game. We're in the top of the sixth inning. One run home here for TJ. So they were able to erase that one run deficit. Well, hey, folks, gives us an opportunity to remind you that if you want to purchase a DVD copy of this game or any other game that we have televised here this baseball season, there's the website, www.ispn.tv. Also have all those high school games from season ago, that TJ Doherty game that was played in the snow here at All City Stadium, one of the craziest games we've done. But, again, purchase a DVD copy of this game, ispn.tv. And there you see Coach Karsh walking back off the field with that noticeable limp.
Well, it gives us time to remind you also that the top tens are up there at ISPN.TV. Surprisingly, neither one of these teams in the top ten. But
Grand Maloney, the sophomore, hitting in the number nine spot. Trying to put his team ahead for the first time this afternoon. Ground ball left side of the infield. Bridge has it. Long throw over to first. It's in time. And we will remain tied at two. But TJ gets the equalizer as we head to the bottom of six. Score remains tied at two apiece here. Bottom of the sixth inning, 2-3 and 4 due up for the East Angels here in the sixth.
Makes it hard for any hitter just to stand up there and take a walk.
The payoff pitch. Ground ball right side the infield. And safe at first will be Bridge. And here's Jamie Lehman Miller.
Well, four out of six innings. He's been able to get that lead better on.
Like Freeland, that wasn't even close.
I don't know if I've ever put one to the backstop that way, and it's a long time ago when I played baseball. But you have a tendency as a pitcher. You see the runner going, and you're already coming home. There's nothing you could do. You just try to hurry and get it home. And he might have been trying to throw a slider, so it got away from him, thinking, if I hurry, he forgets to get on, I think, Freeland. Threw over to first, and it ended up 1-3 and 6, I think, is the way that it ended up.
TJ in a bit of trouble. Nobody down the inning, a heart of the order. Due up here in a four-pitch walk now to Lehman Miller. And again, Torrey Humphrey, skipper for TJ, was just out there a moment ago. Runners at first and second with nobody out. And again, there was some action in that TJ bullpen just moments ago when they were at the plate. They do have a couple of arms loose. And the two lead pitchers down there, Keenan Moore, who has not entered the game yet here this afternoon, and also getting a little bit of work was the right fielder Van Dyke. Warming that arm up a bit if needed.
You saw Coach Howard Karsh for East talking to Zavala. An RBI single back in that first inning. Talking to him about situational hitting. You don't have to do too much. Nobody out. Put the ball in play somewhere.
There's a one hopper. It goes off of the glove of Thornton. Rounding third, coming home and scoring the go-ahead run. Max Bridge, and it's 3-2.
Why do you like that? Zavala's come through. A couple of RBI singles there. That a hot shot that took a high hop, and Thornton trying to get that glove up there. He's going to feel bad about that, but that was a hot shot that took a high hop there. And he would have liked to have knocked it down, but again, that thing was moving. He smoked that ball. Freeland, of course, is your knuckleballer. He's got that hard slider that comes in. So Maloney's had to really work very hard on the other side of things. You know, Boris, the battery mate with Wilson, and he's had his work cut out for him, too.
This ball is smoked. Gap left center field. That is big, big trouble. Lehman Miller will score. Rounding third, Zavala, he will score. A two-run double for Lars Hager. And it's 5-2 East.
Big, big day for Hager. 3 for 3, couple runs batted in. That may be the one that will send Freeland off to the bench here, as we see Coach Torrey Humphrey coming out here and gonna at least talk to his team, be his second trip out there.
Pitching change here in the sixth at All City Field.
You know, in baseball, a lot of times they pull a lefty out and you're thinking, whew, lefty's done. All right, I can see a righty. Not the case. Here comes another one.
Swing and a miss, so Henry is able to come in and register the first out of the inning with the strikeout of Houston.
Henry's got a little more Tabasco sauce on that fastball than what Freeland had, so it's going to take a little bit for the East hitters to catch up.
Yeah, Freeland is a guy that's not going to overpower yet. They've been in situations this year where you have Freeland that starts, and then you bring in Van Dyke as a relief pitcher, and Freeland fastball tops at 75, where Van Dyke can throw it 86, 87.
Yeah.
In fact, Van Dyke was clocked this past summer at 88. He's just a sophomore. Still can't get over the youth of this TJ baseball team as Porras is at the plate.
First name, Yvonne, Ivan. You wonder, do you think he's got a nickname because he's a catcher?
That's a good point.
I don't want to stick it on the young man if that's the case, but got to figure his East teammates have called him that at least once.
Once again, Henry working an 0-2 count. 1-2.
Tried to come in with a slider that time. Nasty little waist pitch. Porras was certainly thinking about swinging at it.
The 1-2 popped up out of play over the press box here at All City Field. Just a reminder, we'll be back at All City Field a couple more times here this year. We'll be back out here for that 5A Championship Series, day one of the Championship Series. Always one of the best days in high school baseball. You have the final eight teams, and always see great matchups. Usually you get the number one pitchers that throw in the first matchup of the championship series. But we had a great game last year with Taylor Rogers, the lefty from Chatfield. And we'll also be out here on May 16th for the 5A state championship game. This one lined into right center field. They're going to round Hager from third. He'll score easily as the cutoff throw was bobbled out in right center, and it's 6-2 Denver East.
Big drive that time for Porras. Just went with the pitch. Fastball delivered it right out there to the gap in right.
Second run driven in of the afternoon for Porras. And they will have a courtesy runner for the Denver East catcher, as Anthony Arrieta will be out there to run.
That slider will really tail in toward that back foot.
That hit him?
Must have. I call it back foot. Must have caught it that time.
Get the game-tying run at the top half of the inning to tie it up at two. It's a good breaking ball, and down on strikes is Greenwood for the second out of the inning.
That'll get you in trouble. Both of those things will get you in trouble there, and it kind of snowballed from there.
There's the top of the order, and boy, that ball hammered into left field, and what a catch by Deshaun Turner in left. I don't think he saw it initially off the bat. He got a tough jump on it, and again, you look right into the sun when you're in left field at All City Field here this time of day, and that's one of the best catches we'll see all year. The damage is done. Four runs in. It's 6-2 as we head to the seventh. Very well played baseball game here this afternoon. Trying to get, I don't know if there was some defensive changes out there in the field. And in fact, Jay Nagami is now playing second base for the Denver East Angels. Three balls and two strikes here to Thornton.
Let's go! Let's go!
Stands at 5'3". And crouches down. You can see him there. That's a small strike zone. Lifts that one deep into left field. Going back on that one is Zedis. and enough room will make the catch. First out of the inning.
Nice play by the lefty, left fielder that is, Zettis out there, ran to the spot. Took the step back, identified where that ball was, ran to the spot, turned back around and spotted it up and made the catch. And see if Wilson can finish it off. 103rd pitch here.
That ball lifted into center field. Lehman Miller tracked back on it initially. It was the right move. And there are two down, TJ, down to their final out of the evening.
Played a pretty clean ball game here.
Good curveball there. Wilson was able to backhand it to throw to first, and it got away from the first baseman, Houston. On his way to second base goes Needham. So there is life yet in the Spartans of Thomas Jefferson.
Wilson did a great job to get to that one, backhand it, and then set his feet. He gunned that thing over to Houston. Boy, there was a lot of mustard on it.
Tied the game at two apiece. A four spot in the bottom half of the sixth by East has put the cushion to four. Fly ball into right field. And the catch was made. A beautiful catch by Brown, and that will finish it out. And I said it was Thomas, but it was Van Dyke. It was actually at the plate, and he'll fly out to end the contest. Well, six hits lead to six runs for Denver East. Two runs on eight hits for TJ. East gets the victory. They go to 13-4 on the season. Meanwhile, TJ playing a tough stretch here. They fall to 5-9 on the year. Our postgame show, it comes up next here on CET Sports.
All right, post-game show. Back we come here, and we get to name our Skate City players of the game. Of course, we got to go with Anthony Wilson, a complete game win here, just giving up a couple of runs, and Lars Hager as well. 3-for-3, couple of runs batted in. Congratulations on the win. I'm going to start with you first of all, Anthony. Let's talk a little bit about your pitching. I see the ice in the arm. How you feeling? Complete game, controlled things pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, it was pretty good. I felt pretty good the whole game. My arm was pretty fresh. I couldn't really control my curveball as much as I wanted to, but my fastball was working. I was hitting some good spots, so I was doing pretty good. So.
Sixth inning, they started to put it on you a little bit there. A little bit of trouble. You got out of it, though.
Yeah, I was a little scared, but I've been through it a little bit. I've been through it. I've had a lot of experience with the hard times of the baseball field, so. Been doing good.
Did a nice job. Got a win. I know you guys got a few more games to go, but congratulations to you. I'm going to turn and talk to your mate over here, Lars Hager, 3-for-3. That's not a bad way to you broke things out finally here for East in the sixth.
Yeah, I don't know. We got some big defensive plays too from Jamie, center fielder, getting the kid out at home. That's big. We just really got into the game.
Did you guys feel good here? I mean, it was a tight ball game. Obviously, this is a big rivalry game. It's been a while since you guys have beat TJ, though.
Yeah, we felt good coming out. We knew we should beat these guys, and we did.
All right. Talk about headed into districts here. I know you got a few more ball games on the plate, but talk about how the team's coming together here.
Well, we just got to win these next two games. But we're coming together. We got a lot of chemistry, but we just got to go out and win these next two right here.
Congratulations to both of you. Good luck down the road, and we'll see you in the playoffs, I'm pretty sure. Anthony Wilson, of course, and Lars Hager, our Skate City Players of the Game. Let's talk to Coach Karsh. I appreciate you making your way over here and talking to us. We watched you hobble out to the mound at least one time, but that's about the only time you really had to go out and talk to Anthony.
Well, I tried to tell the kids I tore a calf muscle the other day. I took a bad step, and I said, you know, let's just take care of business and get this over with. And, you know, you mentioned Anthony. One thing that I'd like to add, a couple things, is three days ago, he was coming home from a ball game and was hit between broadside and straight on by a drunk driver. And his girlfriend is fighting a good fight. She's going to be fine, but she's got a lacerated liver and spleen and some internal injuries. And you know, we're glad to have Anthony here. And the club's had a lot of adversity lately. We also have a kid that I'd like to just mention say a little hello if he's watching. We have a kid in Children's Hospital. He's a sophomore. His name's Addison Squibbs, and he's fighting cancer pretty bad right now. And we're hoping that he'll pull through it. And he's got about 6 months of chemotherapy, and we always have him in our hearts with us. And as you mentioned with the other guys, it's been a struggle the last few years with TJ, but we have a lot of seniors on this club, and the kids really work hard. And And we've done a lot of emphasis on technique and coaching the mental game and teaching it this year. And I think it's finally starting to show. So hopefully we'll have a great year. And this is a good win for our program. So I'm just really proud of our kids.
Yeah, I want to kind of add on to that. You talked about it being a very good win. You talked about the adversity that your team has had to fight through a little bit this season. I didn't see any panic out there. I just saw pure, clean baseball, even when TJ tied things up. Anthony goes out, pitches a good game. You get good, solid defense behind, and the bats come alive at a key time.
Well, yeah, Lars had a big hit. He got robbed on a game-winning situation similar to that earlier this year against Kennedy. But the thing about Anthony, he's not real big, and he's actually a great little shortstop. He's one of the top shortstops in the state. But he's a kid that can throw three pitches, first strike. It's curveball, fastball, and he's got a nice changeup as well. And like I said, we've just had so much going on in our program. My big worry about him was getting too geeked up. Yesterday, he was cleared by all the doctors and he played, but he was kind of like a lost little soul out there and had a good meal and slept a lot and came out and did a great job. And this, I'm really happy for our seniors because it's a great bunch of kids. We've got tons of scholar athletes. We've got numerous kids with over 4.0 grade averages. And I'm very happy for the kids.
Yeah, it's a big win. It'll push you into districts. We wish you the best of luck as you head into districts, too.
Thank you very much, gentlemen, and it's always a pleasure to see you. Have a great night.
All right. Howard Karsh, head coach there for the East Angels. Big win.
Well, again, the final score, 6-2, is a 4-run bottom of the sixth for Denver East to break a 2-2 tie. They go on to knock off Thomas Jefferson. Thanks to our entire crew here today from All City Field. For Gary Stebbins back in the truck, the rest of the crew, my broadcast partner in the booth, Scory Lopez. I'm Brian Roth saying so long, and thanks for watching High School Baseball here on CET Sports.